following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Be impeccable with your word. Express your love. Impeccability of the word can be measured by a level of self-love. If you love yourself, you'll express that love in your interactions with others, and that action will produce a like reaction. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 51. NASDAQ is up 83. S&Ps are up 16. Gold contract up $10.10, trading at $13.25 an ounce. We have silver up 13 cents, $16.06 an ounce. Light sweet crude, down 36 cents, $53.87 a barrel. Notes and bonds, they really caught a big bid here. You get the 10-year note, up a half a point, 16 ticks, 122.16. 30-year bond is up a full point, plus 6 ticks, 146.28. They both, folks, are going after their highs, and they very well could be an ABC structure on the way up. Big numbers here. King dollar is up 289 ticks. That's trading 95.320. Now, King Dollar is going to get interesting here, but we're dealing with that. Let's get over and just take a look at King Dollar first. So we've been battling this number. It's the 95.830 number. That battle between the bulls and the bears has been happening since October 28th. Bottom line, what you got out here today is that you do have 22,000 contracts traded. So you get some good contract volume. What you have done thus far, though, is you're rejecting lower price once again. It's coming into 29,000. We got down to a price point of 94.875. Let's look at this intraday. So intraday, yeah, you get some buyers here, man. They want to try to get this thing back above that number. Well, I don't expect it's going to go there right now. But bottom line, those bulls and bears are fighting out there like wildfire. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. If we go over to the NDX, let's go to the 3Qs first. Because when we go to the SPY is kind of right where I thought this market was going. On the 3Qs, we're also laid out right there. Actually, right to the penny, which is pretty amazing. So 167.81 is the low of the 11th of October. That low is established 143 million shares. Right now, we are 26 million. We did 41 yesterday, so the bottom line is that you do have a contraction with volume. Now, that being said, when I go over to Amazon, Amazon's going to come out with numbers tonight. And Amazon right now, there's been, no doubt, quite a run coming off this bottom. Amazon bottomed on December 24th, $1,307. What you're doing out here today, folks, is you're taking a B point out with volume. So when you come out with numbers, now Facebook did this last night. You know, here, I'll pull up Facebook first. When we were watching Facebook, I was speculating that it was an ABC structure up with a 170 pivot, A to B equals C to D. Well, that's what it was. It hit 171.68 today. And what it was, Facebook was pushing into its swing area with an expansion of volume. It was pushing into the 152, and bottom line, you know, blew it away, had the volume, finishing the whole ABC structure up. Now, if we get over and we take a look at Amazon, what you're going to see is this. Amazon today has done 6.4 million shares and you only needed 6 million shares, not to have an ABC structure up. So it's a big one. Your A point is 1307. Your B point up here, I'll just do it 1307. 1676. So you got, what's that, 300 and basically 70 points, which is a mind blower. And then that would put that is at, let's see, 300. That's 1890. That's 1960. This is a big number, man. So 1960, the high is the 2022. Amazon today is going to be looking for, let's see how much money they're going to be looking for. Gross revenue, they're going to be looking for $71.9 billion, and earnings per share, $5.56. So we'll see where that shakes out. Now, for that, that brings us right back to the Qs again, because what you have here is that if, in fact, that Amazon does that ABC structure up, these Qs are going to move, folks. And the futures will be open when we get that number on Amazon at the close. Now, there's a differential between the Qs and the SPY, and here it goes. So here, now let me go to the back of the Qs again for a second, because what I suspect we're going to see is this. So the Qs are at the same place where I speculate this market could go, which is the August 11th number. Well, that's 167 in the Qs. Well, the 10th is 171.50. I suspect this is where the Qs want to go, and it wants to try to dig into that bar. And this is going to be set up really well because of the fact that tomorrow is the first. We got window dressing happening until next Monday. So I suspect next Monday or Tuesday is going to be the day that I suspect I'm going to throw the shot back on this market. If we go take a look at the SPY, what you're going to see is that the SPY is weaker. The volume is dying on the vine right now on the SPY. You know, we'll see whether it can do 92 million. We did 92 million yesterday. See, the formula would be that you do a contraction of volume even today. You just hit the number today. We're coming into 274 million, and you're going to do that all of about, who knows, about 80, 85 million, something like that. Now, if we get over to the Dow Industrials and we take a look at the Dow, what you're going to see is that the number on the Dow Industrials was 24,899. And you can see yesterday what we did is that we hit 25,109. And this is where it's stalling right now. That's the reality. The Dow has already stalled. In fact, if we take a look inside the Dow Industrials to see who the movers are out here, you get Dow DuPont is putting a negative 35 points in. Boeing's putting a negative 35. Goldman's 31. These are all negatives. Visa's 27. Let's go look at Goldman out here. So Goldman Sachs. Yeah, it's not that bad. That's a small pullback compared to what Goldman has already done. Goldman, let's see, 205. We haven't hit the 205. We hit 203. It almost looks like Goldman could get into that 205 number. There's going to be lots of action, not only coming into the close. Numbers coming out tonight. Big numbers coming out tonight. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. We have the Dow Industrials down 82. NASDAQ is up 70. S&P's up 11.5. Come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow is up, down 66. NASDAQ is up 77. S&Ps are up 13. Let's go take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here. And it looks like this is going to be a low volume market out here today. You have General Electric. That's up $1.16, trading $10.21. Advanced Micro is up $1.21. You got Microsoft down $2.30. They came out with numbers last night. Facebook's the big one out here today. Up, that's $16. Dow DuPont, they came out with the warning. Bottom line, it's down 520. You get PayPal is off 444. That's unusual about PayPal because all these credit card companies are doing pretty well. NVIDIA is up $5.58. We get over and go take a look at the gold market. What you have with the gold market is this, folks. Gold contract, GCJ. Gold contract right now is trading at 1326. You have 210,000 contracts, so it's good contract volume. If we put this on a continuous contract, you can get a clearer picture of what this market is looking to do. So put this back a few years. What you're going to see is that you just took out the a B point. The real question is going to be, I can bring up the GLD and see if we get an ABC structure on the way up. But it looks to me, either way, you're making a run right now to 1365. 1365 is the highs of the consolidation that we've been in for basically 6 years. Now, what I'd really like to see here is this, is that when you make a run, as we are doing right now in the gold market, meaning that it really hasn't stopped since 1161. If we hit 1161 in basically September, you know, you're 5 months later, bottom line is that, you know, you're 1319. What I'd like to see is a little sideways movement and a pause before we go after these, the top of the consolidation. The reason being is that when you just do straight line moves like this, you can get exhausted by the time you get to the top of this range. So we'll see how that shakes out. We'll see whether it can just lay right underneath this for a week or 2 weeks. That would be like the ultimate, you know, because then your probability gets much higher that you're going to blow right through this. And the number we're talking about inside that gold market is going to be the 1375, 1377. If we go take a look at the GLD, and we line that up, and take a look and say, okay, let's put this back Oh, this is going to be pretty cool. Look at this. 50 million. It's going to be a close call. We very well could have a nice ABC up here. This is awesome. Okay, so your A point on this would be 113. Your B is going to be 122.5, so about 9. That's going to give you a 131. Okay, so your GLD is also saying that we're going to the top. Now, and what's going to happen, the GLD, we'll see what kind of juice that we get coming into the close as well as tomorrow. But what does happen with the GLD, let me see how this is shaking out per day. Yeah, this is cool. So the GLD, we're at 7 million right now. We're probably going to end up doing 10 or 11 million. If we do that tomorrow, you get an ABC structure, a confirmed ABC structure on the way up. Let's go over and take a look at the silver market and see what's happening in silver. Silver caught a nice bid out here also today. Silver right now is up 0.9%. Now, silver was another 13 cents higher earlier because what the dollar has done, the dollar has made a basically run topside once again. It's not topside yet, but it certainly rejected lower price. So silver out here, this is a nice setup. Yeah, silver still has got the volume inside of it. If I take a look at this on a continuous contract, you're at $16.07. Well, it's a good move, man. Yeah, this is pretty intense, actually. Silver, you know, when you line this up on a monthly, silver looks like 21 bucks is game here, and game in a big way, because what we have done is that we're just breaking that trend line from the $21 level. And we get a decent day tomorrow, you're going to have a break of that trend line with conviction. And conviction is that you have the wide price spread, you have the volume come into it. Bottom line, it looks like that's exactly where we're going. And if that's what it is, that's going to get really intriguing. The reason being is that when we made this run in 2016, that's the high of 2016. And this would be a different flavor. The reason being is that because we built cars up for such a long period of time, this thing breaks topside. This can absolutely take out the $21. And then you're talking action, because then you're talking somewhere up to $28. And we haven't been at a silver $28 in so long. That's April of 2013. So you're talking about a monster a time frame as well as number there. We go take a look at, okay, so the bonds. Look, these bonds are amazing. So right now what you have is that your 10-year is at 2.624. Now, we bring this up, what you're going to see when we bring this up is that you're going after, I believe it's the January high. Yeah, January 3rd high. We've done 1.6 million contracts. So you're coming into this and you have volume behind the move. Now, this very well, folks, could be an ABC structure on the way up. And the mind blower is, if it is, it's a beauty. 117.15 is your A. 123.08 is your B. So what did I say? 117. So you get $3. You get $6. You get $5.50, because you got to remember something. It's 32 ticks inside a point. So $5.50 gets you 126.5. All right, yeah, 126.5. So if we take a look at this and we put this on a generic continuous contract, 126.5, let's remember that number. Okay, so, well, that's not the one I want. TY, 126.5. Okay, this is the one I want. We pull this back. I like it. Actually, so this is your next swing point up here is 128.03. So that sets up that you can actually go after this 128.03. When we get inside, so the next big move here, our number to keep your eye on is going to be 123. What 123 does is this, folks. That gets you in the higher range. The all-time high in the 10-year right now, I believe, is 135. Let me make sure of that. Yeah, it is. Yeah, 135. You know what's so intriguing out here is that we can go all the way back to like 2008, you know, and this is what the rate structure was in 2008, meaning this low of rates. If we do go over, and I'll do this quickly, to go look at the 30-year. This is the 30-year is like, this thing is like not only on fire, but when we bring this back, what you're going to see is that the 30-year, bottom line, let's see, 148. Okay, inside 148.04, we're at 146.27. Inside 148.04, that would get you inside the larger range. And that would say that, hey, you can actually go for the high of 177. Pretty amazing. 877-927-6648. We have the Dow Industrials down 53. NASDAQ is up 77. S&P's up 14.5. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials down 53, NASDAQ up 77, S&P's up 14. And, you know, this Arctic air blast, folks, is something else. It actually took down a nuclear reactor. Well, they basically took it down in New Jersey. What this is about, the Arctic blast wreaking havoc across the U.S. It was cold enough to shut down a nuclear reactor thanks to a rare phenomenon called frazzle ice. The Public Service Enterprise Group shut one unit at its Salem nuclear plant in southern New Jersey early this morning after intake screens froze over, restricting the flow of water needed to cool the reactor, according to the spokesman. The 60-foot tall intake screens rotate in and out of the water, preventing debris like floating wood from entering the plant. Under extreme conditions like this week, overnight low temperatures at the station fell into the single digits. The fragile ice can accumulate on the screens, blocking the flow that caused water circulation to shut down and prompted the Newark-based public utility to take the plant offline. We had heaters running, we had folks out there, and we lost the four circulators within 5 minutes. We wouldn't say, he wouldn't say when he expected them back up in service. Pretty intense. This weather that basically went across there, there's no doubt. Big numbers, and hopefully, it looks like today, I believe, is going to be the kind of the, not the end of the cold weather, but the end of that vortex that dropped those temperatures in Chicago to 25 below normal temperature, never mind how bad it can get in the aspect of wind chill. Microsoft. So Microsoft came out with numbers last night. They were a little light. Microsoft's down 230. That being said, Microsoft still wants higher price. You know, you're backing down. You didn't break the little swing from Monday. Monday had a low swing out here of a 102.17. You back down at $2.50 today, 220, and there's not enough to basically croak this thing right now. So it's kind of intriguing, even in the space that Microsoft is in, that they, bottom line, can't push them back. GE, so let's take a look at GE. So this is what you have with GE. You know, we bring GE back, and you know, this is gonna be a classic, and the reason this is gonna be a classic is this, folks. As GE come off the bottom, you know, the bottom line, the speculation was going to go to 987. Why 987? 987 is the low of the last time it had monster volume on the way down. Well, we went to 1077. Now, you're up here, and you're actually up here with good volume, you know. So you get a confirmed ABC up. Let's take a look at how that shakes out. So you get 666. Well, you get $2.50, which gets you $10.68. And you can see you went to 1077. Now, let's put this back in on a weekly. So what we have on the weekly is this. On the weekly, you're still coming into that bar. It's not going to have the volume. So the number to keep your eye on here is going to be $11.73 to $9. And, you know, this has been the first substantial bounce that GE has got since, let me see how many years here. Well, since $32. We were at $32 December of 2016. And what you have here with GE, let's see what they're saying. So they paid $1.5 billion to settle the subprime mortgage. And that's good. That's another one out of the way for GE. Bottom line, they did not put any more, when they come out with numbers out here, they did not put any more. Well, let's see exactly what they did. I believe they didn't have to put any more in reserves. They claim they didn't put any more in reserves for their insurance, their long-term health insurance. We'll see if that's going to still come back and bite them. The number here goes like this. So the consensus was 22 cents. They made 17. What they did do is this, folks. They wrote off an additional $750 million of book value. Now, I think the way that they're going to try to massage this is that, so picture what happens. They're in the middle of, you know, a lot of different scandals. The biggest one, I would say, has to do with basically cooking their books. And the way that it seems to be coming down, the way the books were being cooked, where that they were not giving a fair market value to their businesses, meaning that the businesses were already destroyed. And what ends up happening, of course, as those businesses are destroyed, meaning dollar-wise, you have to write them down. If you get something on your books that's saying worth $300 million, and guess what, you're not making any money more than that, well, guess what, it's not worth $300 million on your books, on your balance sheet. It's probably worth $200 million, $100 million, $250 million. There's a number there that's associated with it. GE, bottom line, they wrote down this quarter, $750 million. No one has a good handle on how many more write-downs are going to be out here. The market today is saying, hey, $750 is not bad. We think we got something going. Bottom line, I still wouldn't buy GE. You know, and you hear folks, it's pretty wild, actually. Analysts are out there. Plenty of people out there saying, hey, listen, you know, GE under $10 was great. You know, great company. Well, guess what? Great company that has been going one way for basically, I bring this back. So GE's trading at the same price it was trading in 1995, folks. 1995. I just brought this back 50 years. So the high in GE was in 2000, $60. Your next high was in 2007 at $42. Your next high was in 2016 at $30. And what you do have, you know, it came all the way down to test that high volume low that was laying out there in 2008. And bottom line, we'll see whether, you know, that's it. You know, it's, right now it's telling me that we're still going to go back down into that lower level. And all we actually are doing is a dead cat bounce. See where that shakes out. Franco Nevada, FNV. So let's go take a look at Franco Nevada. Franco Nevada out here is at 77.40. Why Franco Nevada? This is one of the biggest royalty stocks in the gold market. It's laying right next to its highs, and it looks like it's going to be going for them. What Franco Nevada has done out here this week, the $75 level is the level to get over the consolidation to make the run for 86. And Franco Nevada's done it. We still got to tomorrow. It's got to stay over $75.71. Right now, you're $1.80 over that. But you can see the move. The move itself is pretty extraordinary, meaning this week we just went from 72 to 77, 41. And that is an indication. Well, let's look at the Royal Gold, too. Oh, this is good. Look at Royal's on the move, too. This is real good. So Royal, in five trading days, just went from 80 to 87. We pull this back. Oh, this is impressive. Okay, so this is going after its high, too. $100 is its high in 2012. Our last high was at 98. Making the move. And now, when royalty stocks make the move, folks, your probability is pretty good that the gold contract is going to continue higher. Dow Industrials down 34, Nasdaq up 83, S&P's up 16. We'll come right back.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. If you'd like to be the bank and get the type of interest they receive instead of the low interest rates they give to clients, then I have an investment you may want to take a look at. I'm offering four-year secured first mortgages on buildable city lots in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment can be anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000 per buildable city lot. The interest paid is 7% per year, paid monthly. Depending on the investment, the income per month per lot ranged from $175 for a $30,000 investment to $437.50 for a $75,000 investment. If you are in the CD market, you want to look at this investment. St. Petersburg is located in Pinellas County, which is the densest county in Florida. If you're looking for an investment with your principal intact that pays a good interest rate, this may be for you. The supply is limited, so act now. For more information on these secured first mortgage opportunities, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter. And if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN and you'll find the path of least resistance under trading newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrial is down 32. S&P is up 16. The NASDAQ is up 79. And bottom line, folks, let's go over it in... We're going to watch Amazon, how it's coming into this close out here. So you get Amazon hit a high out here of 1736 today. You're at 1708. I love these days, folks, because the bottom line is that it's taken its swing out high out. It's taken it out with volume. And it's going to be really interesting to see where this shakes out coming right into the 4 o'clock time frame. It's confirmed ABC structure up, and it's a monster too, by the way. So it's going to be really intriguing watching this shake out. If we go over into the option market and we take a look at the options that are expiring in the second week. Whoa, what happened there? Okay. AMZN. Okay, so if we take a look at the money, 1707. Yeah, they're still $68. So you got 2 weeks. Let's see. No, it's not 2 weeks. It's the third Friday. Oh, except that, no, you know what? Yeah, it is. So this is what ends up happening in February option expiration, folks, because the first Friday, yeah, it's the 15th. It's always the third Friday the monthlies expire. So in this particular case, you're paying $68. For and at the money, which, you know what, if it's an ABC structure on the way up, it's not that bad. You know, because that means, bottom line, it has to go up $68 just to break even, just to break even. Yeah, let's go take a look at Deutsche Bank. So Deutsche Bank, this is down 44 cents, trading at 885. Now, that being said, they're actually facing, you know, today there's a whole bunch of press all over the place. That they basically have about another 2 months to get their act together. You know, the government's going to basically, the German government's going to come in and basically make the merge with someone. So this is going to be pretty wild watching how this whole thing shakes out. You know, if we take a look at Deutsche Bank, what you're going to see is that the year 2007, it was $125 stock. Now you're down here at $8.85. So that is one monster number. And Deutsche Bank, if we take a look at revenue, yeah, they're still contracting. So they took in $33 billion 5 years ago, 4 years ago, 4 years ago, $25 billion now. And you can see every segment is contracting on them, every segment. They're going negative by 4% a year in Germany. They're going negative by 10% a year in the United States, 4% a year in the United Kingdom. Asia, they're deflating by 5.5%. So this company, now there's a company, this is a company that I suspect it has so many accounting gimmicks and accounting frauds. It's just one after the other after the other, particularly one of the biggest ones. Is basically money laundering. And that Dance Bank. It's hard to there's a small tiny bank, folks, and it's hard to comprehend that how you can launder like something like $250 billion came out of that small little bank through Deutsche Bank. Bottom line, they're all paying fines up the yin yang in this particular case, but fines now are just one part of the business. Let's go take a look at the SLV. So the SLV, SLV. Yeah, so that's the iShares Silver Trust. The low for the year is 1311. The high is 1644. And this here, oh, let me see that. Okay, so 17 million. No, you don't have an ABC up. Put this on a weekly. 54 million we're gonna need. We're not gonna get an ABC up in the weekly either. That being said though, it wants to go to 1628. 1628 is the next number. And what we have had, oh, this is kind of interesting. Yeah, so what we have just done is that, you know, we had this, the last downdraft in the metals started in June of, last year. It bottomed out in December, November to December. And now what has happened is that you are back in the higher range again. So that inside the silver market, that's saying first you can go for $16.28, and we'll see how it does once it gets up to that level. Let's go take a look at a few of these silver equities. We take a look at Hecla first. Yeah, it's got a nice run today. So Hecla is going after 293. Now this stock here has had some trouble. Yeah, it's moving though. Pan American Silver, that's at 1488. That looks like it wants 1553. You get First Majestic at 609. 637 seems to be game there. Great Panther. GPL. Oh, look at here. So this got some real juice in it today. This could be cool. So Great Panther, actually, how many? We got 12 minutes left. We'll see whether they can get this. That ain't gonna do I won't do the number, but Great Panther took out the 77 cents today. That's the next stop up here is like 94 cents to a buck. We put this on a weekly. See if you've broken this downtrend yet. Looks like you have. Yeah, you broke it with conviction too. So, yeah, this is a good number. This is a classic, actually. You know, if you take a look, if you happen to be watching Tiger TV, folks, what you're gonna see is this. Is you're gonna see, I got a trend line that's drawn from July of 2018. Bottom line, come up to that trend line, it blew it away with price and volume, so that's on conviction. Then it backed down with light volume, and now it's going up topside again. So it looks like $1.17 is game, and that's a big number. Now where's 2016? That's what I want to see. I see right here. So 2016 is 225. That's why it looks to me that the way that these gold equities are setting up, the way that the silver equities are setting up, it seemed that that's where this whole market wants to go. And what that's going to be, folks, is that that's going to be the August high inside those equities. And if that's what you got, that's quite a move, man. That's quite a move, because it's still quite away from where we are. And that was a straight line move. Like if we look at the GDX right now, the GDX is coming into its swing of 2290, and this is good. You're coming in with volume. So check this out. 162 on the weekly was what you're looking for, right? You're already at 199 on the weekly. That's what two different things are going to happen. When we come into the close out here, the GDX, they put big volume in every day at the close. You know, whether you're going up or you're going down. Just how the net asset value comes in. That is bottom line saying that you're going to have the volume in spades as you get up to these higher levels at this $23 mark, which is a big number, because you get volume coming into that. That's going to be where you can actually bust out of this consolidation. Dow Industrials right now, trading down 20. NASDAQ is up 84. S&P is up 18. Come right back.
The universe provides us with opportunities all the time, and now is no different. In 2006, I invested $2,500 in a two-day Master Trader course taught by Tom O'Brien, then ranked as the number one market timer for gold. The fact is, if you want to be the best, you must learn from the best. Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability and the Market Timer of the Year for 2018. To celebrate this accomplishment, TFNN.com is offering you a free two-week subscription to my award-winning newsletter service, and there's no charge to you until day 15 unless you cancel sooner. That's right, we're waiving the normal upfront deposit, and this offer is available to anyone and everyone, even if you've tried Mastering Probability before. Sign up now, and I'll teach you the tool that identified the bottom in the Dow on January 26th, the morning that led to the largest daily point gain in history. This offer will expire on February 10th, so go to the homepage of TFNN.com now and click on Mastering Probability.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the TFNN methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow, well, just went green. Up 12 points, NASDAQ up 92, S&P's up 21. Percentage-wise out here, what you have the Dow Industrials basically flat. NASDAQ is up 1.3%. S&P's are up 0.7%. If we go take a look at the Dow Industrials, let's just look at this, baby. So the Dow, okay. Yeah, you lay there like this. That is saying that 24,000 899. You're at 25,000. Yeah, this is really saying that game is on here for 25,593. Wow, that's pretty intense. So, and what that is, folks, is that that's the low of the 10th of October. So, the 10th of October and the 11th. That's where all the volume is. Both these days, you got monster volume in the marketplace. But the way this Dow is looking right here, it's like, okay, man, it wants to go there. And as I said a little bit earlier, inside the NDX 100, that looks to me like it also wants to go to the 10th versus the 11th, and that's going to have to do with Amazon. We're going to know that in basically 10 minutes, less than that, actually. It's 3:55 right now. Amazon comes out literally a minute or less after the 4 o'clock close. And what you have out here in Amazon right now, you needed 6.6 million shares now to do an ABC structure up, and you get 7.8. So you're pushing it to the swing point. You're pushing it with volume. And we'll see if, in fact, that's how these babies going to come out. The numbers that they're looking for on Amazon are no doubt impressive. This is going to be the quarter, of course, for the holiday quarter. $71.9 billion they're looking for. To the top line, they're looking for the bottom line, $5.56. So lots of action, and you can expect those NQs. So the NQs right now, which is the NASDAQ futures, they're up $76. You can expect big movement out of these if, in fact, I'm right. We can expect big movement anyway, but if I'm right on the ABC structure, folks, this is going to overtake the high as soon as it comes out. The high of today was 69.43. So this thing will blast up about 30 points, like in about a heartbeat. Stay right there, folks. Going to be coming back with those numbers.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This is TFNN, the Tiger Financial News Network. TFNN, headline news update. Here's Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. We had the Dow Industrials finish down 5. NASDAQ was up 98. S&Ps are up by 21. Gold contract up $9.10, trading at $13.24 an ounce. We had silver up 13 cents, $16.06 an ounce. Light sweet crude down 29 cents, $53.93 a barrel. Notes and bonds, they caught a big bid, folks. You had the 10-year note trading up 16 ticks, 122.16. 30-year bond up 1 point plus 3 ticks, 146.25. Now, both notes and bonds, they continue higher price, lower yield. You have the 10-year right now yielding 2.62. And I expect, you know, low for the last 12 months is 2.5. I expect we're going to be below that within the next couple of weeks, because both note and bond market is going after their highs. King dollar up by 264 ticks, trading 95.295. King dollar looks like it's trying to make it inside this 95.830 once again. Bottom line, we'll see. It's a make or break on a Friday. The euro is trading at 114.47 to one U.S. dollar. The yen is at 108.88 to one U.S. dollar. And the pound is out here at 131.14. We get over and we take a look at that NDX 100, folks. The Qs right now are trading at a price point of 168.16. And what you have there is that the 167 mark was the October 11th low, and it looks like we're a good game on here to the October 10th low, which is be 171.50. And if we do take a look at the NDX 100 right now is trading at a price point of $79, and it's going to be all about Amazon. Amazon's going to be coming out any minute with their numbers. Amazon closed out here today, $1,718, and there you go. You're at 17.46 right now. Maybe they just come out. Yeah, they did. They come out. Bottom line, Amazon's an ABC structure on the way up, and it's a monster, folks. Amazon came out, $71.9 billion was the estimate. They came in with $72.4, and Amazon for the day was up $48. Now you're up an additional $40 on top of that. And it blew away its B point, and it has volume behind the move. Stay right there, folks. Lots more numbers coming out after the close.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Hi, folks, this is Tom O'Brien. If you'd like to be the bank and get the type of interest they receive instead of the low interest rates they give to clients, then I have an investment you may want to take a look at. I'm offering 4-year secured first mortgages on buildable city lots in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment can be anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000 per buildable city lot. The interest paid is 7% per year, paid monthly. Depending on the investment, the income per month per lot ranged from $175 for a $30,000 investment to $437.50 for a $75,000 investment. If you are in the CD market, you want to look at this investment. St. Petersburg is located in Pinellas County, which is the densest county in Florida. If you're looking for an investment with your principal intact that pays a good interest rate, this may be for you. The supply is limited, so act now. For more information on these secured first mortgage opportunities, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom Business Day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look who we have.
It's a beautiful day. Got our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We're going to take it by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We got 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's making a great night, folks. Always do your best, but don't overdo. When you overdo, you deplete your body and you go against yourself, and it will take longer to accomplish your goals. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials closed down 15, NASDAQ up 98, S&P's up 21, gold contract up $9.60, trading at $13.25 an ounce. We had silver up 13 cents, $16.06 an ounce. Light sweet crude down 19 cents, $54.04 a barrel. Notes and bonds, they just continue higher. Higher price, lower yield. You get the 10-year note up a half a point. 166.14, 30-year up full point, plus one tick, 146.23, King dollar up 254 ticks, trading 95.295. The euro is trading at 114.45 to one U.S. dollar. The yen is at 108.92. The pound is at 131.11 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. I know what's going on in your world. In the world of Amazon, let's go take a look at it. So Amazon comes out with those numbers. Amazon closed up $48 today, $1,718. You get a close at. It's trading $1,726. Bottom line, you got an ABC structure on the way up, a confirmed ABC up on the way up. And that was before they come out with their numbers, folks. So here's the numbers on Amazon. They were looking to do $71.9 billion. They did $72.5 billion. So they took in an additional $500 million in 90 days. Not bad, right? The cloud sales, $7.43 billion. The earnings per share number, the estimate had been $5.56. They take in $6.04. You can see that it's pretty amazing. You can kind of see right there. They're at a point, folks. If you just did a fast napkin math on their gross sales, the net sales, versus the earnings, what you're going to see is that every $500 million, they seem to make 50 cents. You know, because what happens here is that you got 500 million more than they were estimated at. The estimate had been 556. They come out at 604. So you're talking some big numbers here. And in Amazon's case, bottom line is that you definitely have an acceleration to the upward side. They're in so many different businesses that are growing so tremendously. It's amazing. So this fourth quarter, folks, sales were up. Let's just get this straight. Yeah, 20%. You got operating cash flow increased 67% to $30.7 billion for the trailing 12 months compared to $18 billion for the 12 months prior to that. Look at that. That's amazing. Free cash flow increased to $19.5 billion for the trailing 12 months. Net sales increased 20% to $72.4 billion in the fourth quarter. So year over year, folks, they're still growing by 20%. Operating income increased to $3.4 billion compared with $2.1 billion in the fourth quarter of 2017. So that's quite a feat. That's pretty amazing, actually. Net income increased to $3 billion in the fourth quarter, or $6.04 a diluted share, compared to $1.9 billion in the fourth quarter of 2017. Net sales increased 31%, big number, to $232 billion compared with $177 billion. Operating income increased to $12.4 billion compared with operating income. Oh, look at that. That's huge. So operating income, folks, increased to $12.4 billion compared with operating income of $4.1 billion in 2017. Net income also big number. So a year over year deal. This is quite a move, folks. Alexa was very busy during the holiday season. Echo Dot was the best selling item across all products on Amazon globally, and customers purchased millions more devices from the Echo family compared to last year, said Jeff Bezos, founder and CEO. The number of research scientists working on Alexa has doubled in the past year, and the results of the team's work are clear. In 2018, we improved Alexa's ability to understand requests and answer questions by more than 20% through advances in machine learning. We added billions of facts, making Alexa more knowledgeable than ever. Developers doubled the number of Alexa skills to over 80,000. Customers spoke to Alexa tens of billions more times in 2018 compared to 2017. For the second year in a row, Amazon was ranked the company America loves the most on the morning consult boards that define 2018. It was named America's most just company on retail. Amazon launched Amazon Future Engineer, a childhood to career program that aims to inspire and educate millions of children and adults about computer science and coding each year from underserved and low-income communities. Through this program, Amazon will fund coding camps and online lessons, pay for introductory and advanced placement courses, and computer science for over 100,000 underprivileged people in 2,000 low-income schools across the U.S. and award 100 students annually from underserved communities pursuing a degree in computer science with four-year, 10,000 annual scholarships, as well as paid internships at Amazon. Pretty cool. That's kicking that education. It's a big deal, folks, and particularly education, you know, inside the coding business is a big deal because that's not going away. We're expanding on that in a monster way. Let's go take a look at Deckers. Deckers just come out. Deckers Outdoor that closed at 128.45. That is trading right now at 137. So we're buying Deckers evidently. And you can see this too. This was pushing on volume. 137 is the last high. Actually, it is the high. So let's see what they have to say. Estimate earnings per share estimate 529. They came in with 659. Big number. Revenue. Look at that revenue too. Big number. 823 million. They came in with 873. So bottom line is that they beat the top and they beat the bottom. And it looks like, you know, the low, it looks like we're gonna go after the all-time high. Yeah, 137.49 is your all-time high, and right now you're trading at 138. Yeah, it's just jumped over its all-time high. Stay right there, folks, come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action.
Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at lots of numbers that are coming out here. Cypress Semiconductor. Now, the low for the year is $11.75. The high is $18.87. This closed at $13.87. And right now, that's at $14.51. Let's see how this setup is. Well, so there's a lot of these folks that were pushing on volume, and they're all a little small ABC. Well, Amazon's a monster ABC. This is a small ABC. Let's go see what they have to say, though. Okay, the earnings estimate was 33 cents. They made 35. So they got two extra pennies there. Revenue, $598 million. They did 604. So in both cases, they got it going. If we go take a look at Edward Life Science, the low for the year is 121. The high is 175. This is a different animal now. This is... Well, it's not bad. It's only going south by $2. Yeah, it's nothing. Actually, 166 to 168 it's trading. Closed at 170. Had been up at $1.82. Numbers go like this. Earnings per share, estimate was $1.17. They came in with $1.17. Revenue estimate out here, $976 million. They did $982. So in both cases, they actually beat. And market-wise here, yeah, this is, all that's happening here is that this is down a couple dollars. It was up a couple dollars today. You know, this is going to be an intriguing one, too, because what you have with this is that this is coming into the high that was generated out here 5 months ago, October 1st. That's where it had come off that high with big volume and, you know, set up a monster consolidation, because the lows of this consolidation is 136. The top of that is 170. So you're talking about some big numbers out here. Symantec, SYMC, this just come out also. This is a very big week for earnings, folks. It's 25% of all the S&P stocks are coming out this week. Symantec, the low is $17. The high is $29. This closed at $21. And right now, this is trading at $22.30. And $22.30, yeah, you get a little pop-up. Let's go to Sam in Melbourne, Florida. Hey, Sam, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. Thank you for taking my call. The weather is getting cold out here today.
Yeah, we have a nerve, Sam, saying that the weather's cold in Florida. I know what you're saying, man, but the poor rest of the country. So what is it, like 45 or 50 there or 60 or 70? What is it?
Yeah, out here, I'd say probably around 45, 50, somewhere around there right now.
Okay, right.
Last night was awful, yeah.
You know, see, it's all in perception, folks.
We say it's awful. You know, I imagine up there in the Midwest, they're in the minus 60 up there.
I know, man. It's so cold. And we're little babies down here in Florida, folks, but come visit us. It's why people keep moving to Florida. Our weather's phenomenal. There's no doubt. And you could see it on the map yesterday. And the map yesterday and the map today, folks, it's the only place that you had like 45 to 55 to 60 degrees in the whole country. Crazy.
Yep.
So what are we going to look at?
Yeah, Tom, I made an earning play on U.S. steel, and it gave me a scare this morning. But the action of the way you're coming back up, does that look good to you or what?
Yeah, it does. Oh, that's interesting. So what Sam's talking about, and I can see that, right? What happens, folks, is that this opened at $20.51, then went down in 1995, and then just came all the way back. And, yeah, you get a small ABC up. So your A point is 1725. You get about $3.50, which gets you 2380. 2380 is the number of a small ABC up. Now, let me put this on a weekly for a second, just so I can. So, on a weekly. Yeah, you can get 2380 out of it. You know, this is not the strongest stock in the world. I mean, if you like the steel stocks, let me see what Nucor is doing, because I remember being on TV a couple weeks ago saying Nucor is the number. Yeah. So
Nucor had good number.
Yeah, just keep that in mind, Sam, because you can see Nucor wants to go to its highs, which is 65, and you're at 61. This is a confirmed ABC up, Nucor. It took out a B point, the A's 50, 61. So you got $8, which gets you 64. Yeah, the high is 64. So what's interesting here is that Nucor did the same thing as U.S. Steel today, which is good. You know what I mean? I mean, they opened it, they closed it, they got it down to the gap. It looks like you get action there. And then you want to go look.
I'm sorry, you know, because the only reason I kind of hold on on the way down for a little bit, because I'm watching AKS and Nucor, they're not going down. I said, something is wrong here, and the report for U.S. Steel is not that bad, but they smack it down.
Well, you know what's interesting? I don't know the parts of the steel business that they're actually in. But when you take a look at U.S. Steel, you know, watch this, I'll pull it back. This has always been the weakest one. You know, it has the biggest name because it's U.S. Steel. But, you know, you can see this thing has never recovered from 2008. 2008, it was trading at $196. You know, crashes down to 19, has, you know, consolidated between 19 and almost, you know, 50 or 60. Last couple of years, they had a hard time getting over 46, but they're different charts that, you know, so.
Yeah.
And the other one you want to look at is.
And another one here, Tom. Go ahead. You were saying something.
So Twitter, right? Is that what you like to look at?
Yes, Twitter. Yeah, I had a put on Twitter.
Okay, so let's take a look at this. The low for the year is 24. The high is 47. You're trading 13.56. Okay, so does this put expire the 15th of February?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm not that far from the strike price.
Oh, that's good.
I'm right at strike.
Okay, that's cool. So let's take a look at it. Oh, interesting. So they're coming out. Oh, this is going to get interesting. So they're coming out on the 7th. Now,
yes.
This, you know, bottom line, this does not have strength going into this, you know, downdraft. Because it had come down, folks, in December, while was the rest of the market, $37 down to $26. It looks like it's having a hard time getting by this, you know, $34 level. So you still might be in pretty good shape here. I think what we're going to see, Sam, is this. Is that you get February 1st tomorrow, so you know the market can get some more buying. Monday, you got to get by Monday. You know, my take on this market is we get by Monday, and what I'd like to see is that I'd like to see us push into like the highs of today. You know, even again tomorrow, have another contraction of volume, and if that's what we get, then it's like okay, the downside is right around the corner once again. You know, so
yeah, because the market overall, you know, you were both you and David and everybody was looking at a turn pretty soon, and I don't know how soon it is, you know, for me to hold on to the 7th.
No,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I wouldn't hold on to the put going into their earnings. That's for sure. But I don't think you're gonna have to. I don't think you're gonna have to, man. I think we're gonna see that before the fact. Because the 7th is next Thursday. My take is that we're going to be going south before next Thursday. Then you'll get a feel of how it pulls back. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yes, yes.
Cooking, brother. Have a great one, man.
Thank
thanks for the call.
Thank you for taking my call.
Okay, thanks. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. And if we just go over to Amazon, again, we just take a look at this quickly. What you're going to see out here is that Amazon closed out at 1718. Right now, you're trading 1680. So this is going to get really intriguing watching this shake out, because this is a confirmed ABC structure on the way up. And what you had here is that this was trading up an additional $40. It was trading at a 1758. Now you're trading at 1680. Volatility in the spades. Now, what also you have inside Amazon, you want to hear an impressive number. This is pretty amazing, actually. So Amazon folks really just start pumping into the advertising business about a year and a half ago. Bottom line is that advertising business, now, it's certainly a lot less than the amount that Amazon takes in per quarter. Like this quarter, they basically took in $72.4 billion. Their business, however, the advertising business, folks, this quarter, they took in $3.39 billion. Now, that's a growth rate in 3 months, however, of 95%. Yeah. You heard it right, 95%. The company's other revenue category, which is mostly advertising, grew 95% to $3.39 billion in the quarter. So you can see that's going to be a big part of their business. It's going to, they're going after it. Tommy and I were talking about this morning. I had read this article about how they're using their 100 million plus Prime subscribers in order to basically dig down into the advertising business and explain to the advertisers that they have a better transactional ad in order to close people, because they can get so granular about what people are actually looking for and what they have bought in the past. So it's going to be quite a move on Amazon, because this is how Amazon likes to trade, too, I'm telling you. Hey, we'll see where this shakes out in the morning, but it's certainly... The volatility is out there, and it is out there in spades. We go take a look at, Boeing was the big number yesterday. Boeing made it didn't make all-time highs yesterday. Yeah, see, this is what's going to be interesting. It's having a problem actually making its high. So, you're going to get, the high is 394.28. Yeah, you get the volume coming into it, though. This wants to bust it. You know, on a weekly basis, you need 20.9 million. We've already done 25. So this is another indication that you're pushing in with volume. And that looks like, let me put this on a monthly. My God. So, this can break topside. Be intriguing watching how this whole thing shakes out. Because the Boeing has been up at this level now for almost 15 months. So it's a high-end consolidation inside Boeing. What we are going to see out here, let's go to the IWM, because October 10th and October 11th, folks, those are your benchmarks out here. The IWM, we're at 149. On the 11th, it's 153. That's quite a way up from where we are right now in the IWM, but I suspect somehow we're going to get there. If we do go back over to the Qs now, we're going to see what the Qs, if we had done this a little bit earlier, let's see what they're trading. 168.16, they're trading 168.10. So you can see Amazon is bringing those Qs down a bit. Now, that being said, what we do have out here is that you have these Qs want to go to 171, so it looks like to me. This is going to be wild watching this whole thing shake out. The reason being is that this has been a big counter trend bounce. You know, from the highs to the lows, you've done, at the 170, you've done a 0.618 retracement. So what also does happen is this. When you do a 0.618 retracement, it is saying that the next time down, you are not going to break those lows. Now, it doesn't mean we won't break them, if you build some cars after the leg down. But that's how this baby is set up right now. So it's going to be intriguing watching how this thing shakes out. If I put this on a larger monthly, and what you can see on a monthly is that you come down with volume. Last low here at 1.4 billion versus 1.1. Yeah, that means you're coming back down again. So what you have here is this. I just put this on a monthly. And the Qs in general, they have a high volume low now. When they were going after that low of February of last year, that was the low. So check this out. This is pretty cool. So we had been talking about the aspect of February of 2018 for quite some time, that we felt that it was going to go after it, test it. This is all the indices. Bottom line, they all did it. Okay? Broke it. They actually not only did it, they broke it too. Now what we have is this. Now, on a monthly basis, you got another high volume low where we broke it. The number on the Qs there was 150. Well, we went down to 143. We did 1.4 billion, and that was 1.18 billion. So you get a tradable market in a huge way. That's the bottom line. Interest rate structure is great for the metal stocks. King dollar. So let's go over the King dollar, because it is intriguing that bottom line is that King dollar, you know, actually rejected lower price out here today. It had 23,000 contracts. The last swing low here, I think it was 29,000. Yeah, it was. So you're going into 29,000, and it did 23. Now, that being said, the number to keep your eye on, the larger number is still 95,830. The smaller number for tomorrow morning is going to be 95,515. Because what 95,515 is, folks, is that's the high of the low that was established out here on January 9th. You know, so what tends to happen is that once you're into that low, it's going to try to get into the high of that low. But you can see the high of that low is still 300 ticks away from the 95,830 mark. And that is the most important one. Into a Friday, most times what you have is this, is that we have a trending metal market up. You have trending gold market up. You have a trending silver market up. Most times coming into a Friday, that would continue. Dollar index, it's going to be a wild one out here, meaning that can they actually push the dollar higher? Because, of course, that would push gold lower. If we go over to the pound, what you're going to see in the pound, there was a sideways move out here today, 130.110. And the euro would be the most important weighting structure-wise inside the dollar index. And that basically gave it up on price today. Got to a price point of 115, closed out in this session at 114. And the yen is no doubt the most important as to where gold actually wants to go. Now, the yen was lower this morning, meaning getting stronger. We got to 108.50 rather, but it rejected it, you know. So now we'll see how this baby shakes out tomorrow morning once again. Just go back to Amazon quickly here. $16.92. It's gonna be cool. We had another 20 minutes. I'm still on the air. You'll probably see it get right back over the 17.17 again. Come right back, folks.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foresight Fund Services, LLC.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
The universe provides us with opportunities all the time, and I was no different. In 2006, I invested $2,500 in a two-day Master Trader course taught by Tom O'Brien, then ranked as the number one market timer for gold. The fact is, if you want to be the best, you must learn from the best. Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability and the Market Timer of the Year for 2018. To celebrate this accomplishment, TFNN.com is offering you a free two-week subscription to my award-winning newsletter service, and there's no charge to you until day 15 unless you cancel sooner. That's right, we're waiving the normal upfront deposit, and this offer is available to anyone and everyone, even if you've tried Mastering Probability before. Sign up now, and I'll teach you the tool that identified the bottom in the Dow on January 26th, the morning that led to the largest daily point gain in history. This offer will expire on February 10th, so go to the homepage of TFNN.com now and click on Mastering Probability.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials finished down 15, NASDAQ up 98, S&P's up 26. If we go over and we take a look at this composite, you know, what you're going to see in the composite, folks, is bottom line, you break top side. In fact, let's go see 18th and the 25th. So if I take a look at this volume on the 18th and the 25th, whoops. Okay, so the 18th we did 2.4, the 25th we did 2.4. Oh, look at this. Okay, you got an ABC up. Oh, this is something else, man. Okay, here we go. We got to figure this one out. Oh, this is going to get interesting. So check this out, folks. We did 2.9 billion out here today. And what we just did, we definitely cracked this consolidation that this composite was in. This could get intense because this looks to me like it. Well, we'll find out whether it got. No, that won't be an all-time high, but let me see this number. So 71.85 is your B point. Your A is right down the bottom, 61.90. That gives you 9.95. Your C on this is plus 69.53. 79. Yeah, you're going to the highs. 79.48 is your number, and the high is 81.33. Now, this is what's cool, folks, that when you put a couple indices together, you know, before Amazon was even coming out, I was looking at the Qs saying, okay, these want higher price than the October 11th and 10th. Now what you have inside the comp's doing an ABC structure on the way up. You got a confirmed one. So you got to be really careful about selling into this at all. Different ballgame. Let me go see if I don't think the SPY had the volume because we need 148 in the SPY. No, you did 102. 127 you needed. So the SPY doesn't have it. The diamonds. Oh, look at this. Yeah, the diamonds got it. We need 5.3 million. Yeah, you did 5.6. So Dow is 216. I can make the case. It's about $31, which gets you 273. Ooh, look at that. I would do this again because that's saying that the Dow would get over its highs. Let me do this again. Okay, so the 8 point is 216. Let's take a call, 217. So it's $30. That'd be 272. And the high is 269. Boy, this is gonna be a trip. Because that is saying, now, what that has just put out, that's saying that the Dow Industrials can do 100% move of a move, meaning go all the way back to the highs of 26,951. It's saying the composite is not going to, the ABC structure is not back to its highs, but right next to them, literally right next to them. You're talking about the highs 81.33, I believe I came in with 79 something. So this is going to be, if you do 100% move of a move and it's a straight line move, that's about as impressive as you can get. Now, what will end up happening, of course, it's going to get tired when it gets to the top of that move. And we'll see whether this is just all about short-term interest rates not going up. If we go take a look at the TLT, you're going to see that's approaching its high. Bottom line, this got juice behind the move. You did 11.5 million shares out here today. And these rates are going to be low, looks like, all year long. 129 is game there. And what you can see, like ASAP, you had Toll Brothers up today, $1.22, $36.94. That's looking to trade up to the $39 level. You go take a look at Lennar. Lennar is up a buck. That's looking to trade at the 52 level. You got some decent numbers out here. And there's no doubt that housing market wise, let's go Home Depot. Which that's looking at. Home Depot has a lot of different ways, meaning just people fixing their house and then people building houses, all of the above. So Home Depot didn't catch a bid as the housing equities actually caught the bid. They caught a pretty good bid. Home Depot is down from 215. You're at 183 right now. Let me pull that article up because those, thanks, Terry, that the new home sales was a monster beat. And I can tell you just from the business in general, and we're in Florida, folks, and what does happen is that we come in season. So when the season starts in Florida, meaning in January, the amount of people that are down here go up exponentially. And so what normally does happen is that the real estate market also goes along with it. And that has happened. There's no doubt. We are busy beyond belief. That right after Christmas, that phone just doesn't stop ringing. And they're coming in and they're closing sales. And, you know, after the amount of cold that hits the Midwest, we have a lot of Midwesterners on the west coast of Florida anyway. We'll have a lot more of them, you know. I just met a couple this morning that just flew in from Chicago. And pitch this, so flying from Chicago yesterday, it's like their flight got canceled four times, but they made it. They got in here last night, and they did make it. We go take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here today. Let's see what we haven't looked at for a while. So you got Marbell was down. DuPont, U.S. Steel, Freeport MacMoran. Let's go take a look at, I know. Well, we know that what happened with Facebook is this. Facebook come out with the numbers, made the numbers, ABC structure on the way up. Now you have a gap with Facebook on the top side. So this always gets intriguing, of course, because what happens, gaps get filled, folks. So what I suspect we're going to have, you know, Facebook no doubt is still making money hand over fist. They grew. Now, their advertising, not their advertising, their daily people that go on Facebook and use it went up 1% in the U.S. That being said, their advertising number went up 30%. So what they've managed to do is this. They're monetizing the amount of people that are on faster than the people are actually coming on, because you can see that number, 1% more people came on, but yet they took in 30% more cash in their advertising business with the same amount of people. That's a big number. It's a huge number. And what you do have out here is that gap, you know, gaps will get filled. You know, we'll see how this does shake out, but gaps get filled. And this is a monster gap. You know, that gap, you closed last night at 150. You open up this morning at 165. That gap's not going to stay open. And particularly what we just did there is we just finished an ABC structure on the way up also. Just check back on Amazon, see if Amazon is back to where it closed out today. Amazon is trading, I love it. So Amazon closed at 1718, trading 1716. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. And this is a pretty cool statistic. Thanks, Terry, for putting this in the den. So the statistic goes like this. After the worst December in a century, stocks in January did the best they've had in 32 years. Pretty amazing, you know, because if we do take a look at that S&P, what you're going to see, no doubt, is that you bring this back. December 3rd, we were at 2,800. And December 24th, you're at 2,351. So you went from 2,800 down to 2,351 for December. That's the worst December. Then, guess what? January, this baby turned on a dime on the 26th. That's when, I believe the 26th was Powell come out. Powell come out with something. We went from 2346 to 2467. That was a monster move, 120 S&P points. And bottom line is that, you just had this movement on the Fed yesterday. And hey, you want to see something that's amazing if you haven't heard this yet, folks. This is really cool. So the Fed fund futures rate, 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago, you had like a 30% chance that they were going to do a rate hike in about 4 or 5 months, right? Now the chances of a rate hike, this even got heavier today, folks, meaning contracted. It's amazing. Right now, there's not a chance of over 0.2%. Yeah, you heard that right. That there's going to be a rate hike going all the way to January of 2020. Now, for a rate cut, look at this. On a rate cut, if you're watching Tiger TV, you're at 10% in September, next September, 15% in October, you're at 24% in December, and you're at 35% in the following January. That's pretty amazing. So now, bottom line, free money is out here. Well, there's no such thing as free money, but the bottom line is that we know that the rates are basically going to stay low. And when you do look at the 10-year, it's been saying it the whole time. The note and bond market have been releasing the most consistent amount of information for quite some time. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. We look forward to speaking right back here tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock. Wow! Go get them, folks.
If you haven't checked the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.